And now it's time to do your first practice set by yourself. This practice set is only putting in invoices. You have to put in the invoices exactly the way you were shown in the previous video. It is very important that you check that your trial balance looks just like this before you begin the practice set. If your trial balance does not look like this, then you should use the preset file that is located on the same page as this video. You should also make sure that your customer balance detail looks exactly like this before you begin the exercise set. And again, if it doesn't, if you had problems with the previous video, then you have to download the file that's located on the same page as this video before you begin the practice set. Here are the invoices that you have to put in for this practice set. You are instructed to put these invoices into the computer in date order. You are instructed by this video to put them in the order in which they are presented to you. Of course, it's possible that you could put them into the computer in a different order and have your accumulated totals become the same. However, if you do not put them in the order in which they are presented, it's possible you will have a problem with future videos. You might need to pause the video in this position so you can more easily read the transactions and record them into QuickBooks. You could also download the transaction list from the Excel file that's located on the same page as this video. Here is what your trial balance should look like when you finished with this practice set. If you have different numbers, don't worry. The following video will help you find and fix any mistakes that you might have made. Here is what the customer balance detail should look like if you did everything correctly and put in all the invoices exactly as they were written. And again, if you have any differences, don't panic. We're going to show you how you can find and fix your mistakes in the next following video.